Hey, my name's Zac Watson and I'm a travel and adventure photographer from Sydney, Australia. Today, I'm gonna be walking you through exactly how I get this moody green color grade on my images inside of Lightroom for mobile. We'll be taking this photo from this to this and I'll be walking you through every step of the way so you can achieve this look on your images as well. So without further ado, let's dive in. All right, now we're inside of Lightroom for mobile. Let's kick things off by correcting the white balance. So I'm gonna dive into color here. And since this image is quite warm, I really wanna dial that down and get to those moody blue and green tones. So first things first, we're just gonna come in here and drop the temperature of the shot. This is going to make things a lot more balanced. However, it's gonna add a little bit of a purple hue in some areas as well. And I don't want that. So what I'm also gonna do is come to the tint and just reduce the tint ever so slightly. I wanna make sure that the blues and the greens are the most prominent colors in this shot. And I still think there's a little bit of room to drop the temperature just a little bit. I would have to say, I think things are looking quite nice there. Making sure you correct your white balance before you do any other edits in your shot is always a good place to start so you can see what colors you're actually working with. All right, so with that out of the way, let's dive into the light tab and get things moving on the exposure. I'm actually happy with the overall exposure of this shot. However, I do wanna add quite a bit more contrast into it. So the way I'm gonna do that is by dropping the shadows, I would say quite significantly, but also raising the highlights. This adds contrast and it also helps that waterfall in the background that's out of focus and not the main focal point stand out as well. So if I just increase the highlights here, you can see that that waterfall in the background and also the light, where the light is coming from above the waterfall, really starts to stand out. Now what I'm gonna do and what you'll see me do throughout this entire video is tap and hold on the screen and then let go. And what that's gonna do is show me a before and after. So this is showing me before and then when I release, it shows me after. I always do this to make sure I'm keeping track of my edit and I haven't pushed or pulled anything too far. All right, so with the exposure controls out of the way, let's dive into the tone curve. I'm not gonna get crazy in depth with the tone curve here, and we're actually not even gonna touch the color curves at all. We're only gonna be touching the RGB curve. First things first, I'm gonna drop 3 points on the tone curve. This one down here is for the shadows, this one here is for the midtones, and this one here is for the highlights. And what I wanna be doing here is I wanna be adding a lot more contrast and pop and just make the entire image far richer. And the way I'm gonna do that is by coming to the shadows dot here and then dropping it. I'm going to increase the midtones a little bit and then also increase the highlights. Now things have definitely gotten a lot contrastier and richer, but in my opinion, they might've just gone a little too far. And the way I like to combat that just a little bit, but by still adding a nice creative flair on my image is to raise the blacks at the end of the tone curve. So if I come into the far bottom left-hand corner of the tone curve, I'm simply just gonna raise this up just a little bit. And you can see as I raise that more, it fades out the darker parts of the image. Now I don't want it to look like this, so I'm just gonna raise it just a little bit like that. And I might also adjust this a touch. I wanna make sure that this midtones are really popping in there. And then I would say things are looking pretty good. We might come here and just dial back the highlights a little bit. And I would say for the overall exposure and contrast level of this shot, things are looking good. All right, so with that out of the way, let's head back into the color tab and then into our color mix tab. This is where we're gonna be able to make the most changes to our color and really start to dial in that moody green color grade. So all I'm gonna be playing with here is the yellows, greens, aquas, there we go, and blues. There really aren't many other colors in this image whatsoever, but let's kick things off with the yellows. Right out of the gate, I'm gonna be dropping the saturation of the yellows. You can see that not too much is affected, maybe a little bit in the background, but I'm gonna desaturate those yellows and then just make them a little bit more on the green side of things. I'm then gonna open up the greens tab, drop the saturation of the greens. Even though we're going for a moody green feel to our shot, I find that desaturating those greens can make the green tones in the image far nicer. So we're gonna slightly desaturate those just a little bit, and we're also gonna move them onto the aqua side just a touch. And then speaking of the aquas, let's dive into our aquas. We're gonna desaturate these, and then we're gonna move them over to the green side a little bit, and then into our blues, where we're gonna desaturate the blues, and you can see there's actually quite a lot of blue in this shot, even for a shot that was taken in the jungle. And surprise, surprise, I'm going to be desaturating these as well. I really don't want any blues to be super prominent in our shot. And like I said just a moment ago, I'm gonna tap and hold on our screen so I can see before and after, and I think things are really starting to take shape. All right, so I'm gonna exit the color mixer tab here and then dive into our color grading tab. Now this is where, once again, we can really start to dial in our Moody green color grade. I'm gonna start with the shadows here and I'm gonna push just a little bit of blue into those shadows. Okay, so, but usually the way I do this is I will come into the shadows and I'll just move things around like this, see what hue really works well with the image. I would say maybe right here looks good. And then I'll scroll down below the circle, hit this little drop-down menu here, and then just make sure I dial back this saturation quite a lot. I find it from time to time a little bit finicky to use this slider here, and it can sometimes change the hue by accident. So just coming down here gives you a bit more of a finer control if you're not super accurate with your touches, and I think things are looking fairly nice. I'm then gonna move over to the highlights, and I might actually add a little bit of blue into the highlights as well. This is mainly affecting the waterfall in the background, but once again, I found the hue, the blue hue that I like, and then I'm gonna come down here and just really dial that back. I find that just making small changes to your image as you go throughout your edit is where things really start to come together. Each individual setting isn't changing all that much, but when you use them in harmony, that is where the magic happens. All right, so now we are done with the color. I would say things are looking fairly nice. Let's get a quick before and after update. Really happy with the colors of this shot. And then I'm finally gonna dive into the effects tab here. And then just a few little things that I like to do to every single one of my photos. First thing is just decreasing the clarity a little bit. It softens out those highlights and it kind of takes away a little bit of that digital edge. And then I'm also gonna add a bit of a vignette in here. I'm just gonna decrease this, which makes the corners, the bottom and the top just a little bit darker. And I would say we are good to go. Anyway, guys, that is gonna wrap up today's video. Here is a quick before and after of today's edit that I just walked you through. I really hope you enjoyed this step-by-step tutorial of how you can achieve this moody green color grade on your photos using Lightroom for mobile.